era of spaceflight has been focused on lowering cost and reusability.
A large lift rocket that's been in service for years will take to the sky from the Cape tomorrow for the second to last time. Our Space Coast Bureau Chief Scott Heidler previews the launch and looks back at its legacy.
The Delta family of rockets, roots dating back to the 1950s, is phasing out. Wednesday's launch, the second to last for the Delta IV Heavy. Over the last two decades, Delta IV Heavy rockets carrying out 15 missions, including this one.
The Delta IV Heavy vehicle is really a workhorse, as you say, for the Department of Defense and for very critical national security assets and large payloads, which are typically things like spy satellites.
The ULA rocket has three core boosters, and this launch will lift one more surveillance satellite into orbit. The parts of the complex 234-foot rocket assembled at Cape Canaveral Space Force Station's Launch Complex 37, where it will lift off with 2.1 million pounds of thrust. The very last Delta IV Heavy mission is scheduled for next year. And then after that, for these big and heavy payloads, there's only one operational rocket that comes even close, and that's SpaceX's Falcon Heavy.
ULA has been phasing out some of their older rockets, and that was just sort of a natural progression anyway. But I think that there's been a lot of pressure from newer companies, obviously other rocket launch companies like SpaceX.
This is the first launch this year for ULA, also working on getting a new rocket, the Vulcan Centaur, off the ground on its first mission at some point this summer from the Cape. But before that next generation of rockets launch, the current generation finishing up its legacy with its last two missions.
The Delta IV Heavy is just about the most expensive launch vehicle aside from the SLS. So in that way, it really wasn't able to compete, and is one reason why we're seeing it get phased out.
On the Space Coast, Scott Heidler, West 2 News.